Using appearances in SwiftUI with the bordered prominent button style can often lead to unexpected UI bugs, especially when the button style conflicts with global appearance settings or dynamic system themes like dark mode. These issues can cause inconsistent visuals or even layout problems across devices and OS versions. In this video, I will walk you through a step-by-step guide on how to implement bordered prominent buttons the right way, avoiding those frustrating glitches and ensuring your UI stays consistent and reliable. And if you like these types of tutorials, make sure to check out my mentoring sessions, where you can meet me on a one-on-one Zoom call. Whether it be SwiftUI, Swift, I can help you with iOS development. Go ahead and check out the link in the description. So today we are going to talk about a little quirky thing that I found out to be a UI bug in SwiftUI. Yes, there are some UI bugs if you don't do it as intended. And it's basically involving the button style of bordered prominent and an appearance of being black and white. So let me show you what I mean by that. So I have prepared here a simple starter demo project with the Excel color demo. And it's basically just a simple demo project. What we have, let's just start off by adding a simple button. And I'm going to get to the problem in just a second. Make sure to follow along. So let's add in here a simple button, action and label. We don't care about the action at this point. And let's add a label of text and then not hello world, just tap me. Fine. It's just tappable, really nice. You already knew this. What if we add a button style of bordered prominent? And as you already most probably know, this is how it looks like. We can tap on it. And if we just switch to our dark appearance, then it just, you know, behaves exactly as we want it. It's really nice. Let's just go back to our light appearance. But what happens, and this is kind of the UI bug, what happens if I select or change the accent color? So how to do that? Maybe I want to set my accent color to be black and white. Now, what do I mean by that? Let me just be real. If you're a SwiftUI developer, having the right mentor can seriously accelerate your progress and help you avoid years of trial and error. That's where my one-on-one mentoring sessions come in. You'll get personalized, practical guidance tailored to your goals, whether you're stuck on a specific problem or want to master SwiftUI from the ground up. With years of iOS experience and a history of helping developers grow, I'm here to help you push past roadblocks and build top-notch apps. Ready to level up? Check out the link in the description. So I'm just going to copy out the exact name, accent color, like you see it right over here. Delete this one and click on plus and add a new color set. Name it, of course, accent color. And let's set the appearance on the light mode for the accent color to be black. That's what I want. So I'm just going to select this one only and then go for 000060. There we go. So in this case, let's just go back to our content view and let's see how it looks like from this perspective. So now we have the accent color. Yeah, it's really nice. So we have the accent color added to the tint of the border prominent button style, which is how it should be. Now, if I tap on it, it looks really nice. What happens if I change the color scheme? There we go. Now we have our issue. Now, what is the issue exactly? Well, the accent color on the dark appearance is white. It's not black as it was previously, it's white. That's what I want actually. But the label also, this text of tap me, also changes according to the appearance of our screen, so our device. So if we are on light mode, it is white. And if you remember, a few minutes, it was actually white, still white, right over here on dark appearance. So that is what we are going to fix. So what we need to do is just tinker with the foreground style of our label. So I'm going to create a new color that is not going to, so it's not going to use the default built-in behavior. It's going to use my own predefined foreground style. So let's just go back to the assets again. And I'm going to create a new color set. And let's just name this, there we go, border prominent label color. And remember, it was on the accent color, it was black and white. Now we want to reverse it because it's just going to pair up. So this one will be white, that's fine. And this one will be black. So let's just go over there and add 6 zeros. Okay. Then let's go back to the content view and let's add a foreground style on the label itself. So dot foreground style, and not white, but border prominent label. So yeah, it's actually recognizing it. And now you see that the label actually became black in this case, in a dark appearance. And then let's just select light appearance. Really nice. Now it's white. So the label is white, the border, the button style, you know, the accent color is black. And then let's just take a look at the dark appearance again. It's exactly as I intended to be. So that's how you can just manage this kind of a strange UI bug when you have your accent color to be, you know, black and white. And if you like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out my mentoring sessions. The link is down in the description.